Why Grijuka Khalsa, Why Grijuki Fateh. A Vaisakhi message from Indrajit, Lord Singh of Wimbledon, Director of the Network of Sikh Organisations, UK. Once again, Sikhs throughout the world are celebrating the festival of Vaisakhi, one of the most important days in the Sikh calendar. Vaisakhi is a tale of brave martyrdom followed by the challenge of new beginnings. The story of Vaisakhi begins with the martyrdom of Guru Tegh Bahadur, ninth Guru of the Sikhs, whose 400th birth anniversary we are celebrating this month. The Guru, who disagreed with many aspects of Hindu teachings, was publicly beheaded by the Mughal rulers for trying to protect the Hindu community's right to freedom of worship and belief. The Mughal emperor then challenged the Sikhs to come forward and claim their master's body. At that time, Sikhs had no distinguishing symbols and hesitated to come forward. The Guru's young son, Gobind, now became Guru, and as he grew into manhood, he constantly thought about how Sikhs should be ready to stand up for their beliefs, however difficult the circumstances. Then he decided to put the community to the test. On Vaisakhi Day, a little over three centuries ago, as crowds were celebrating the gathering of the spring harvest, the Guru emerged from a tent, sword in hand, and asked for anyone ready and willing to give his life for his religion to come forward. A brave Sikh stepped forward and accompanied the Guru into the tent. To everyone's dismay, the Guru then emerged alone, the sword apparently covered with blood, and asked for a second volunteer. After five Sikhs were taken into the tent, the Guru again emerged, this time followed by all five Sikhs who were clearly alive and well dressed in turbans and other symbols that have become the badge of Sikhism. The Guru was clearly overjoyed. The infant Sikh community had proved its courage, and he was now confident it could continue to flourish if it remained true to the teachings of our Gurus and the Guru Granth Sahib, while being on guard against those who wish to destroy the independence of the Sikh faith. We have survived many direct challenges before. Today the threat is from India's Prime Minister Narendra Modi, a lifetime follower of the RSS, dedicated to turn India into a Hindu state. Disguised as praise for Sikh teachings and aimed at absorbing Sikhs into Hinduism, it poses a distinct and insidious threat. The clue lies in the Prime Minister's own words. Our Sikh Guru's tradition is a philosophy of life itself. What does an extremist Hindu leader of a supposedly secular country that has passed discriminatory laws against Muslims mean by our Sikh Gurus? Guru Arjan emphasized Sikh identity when he wrote, "I keep neither the Hindu fast nor the Muslim Ramadan. I serve the one God who is both Allah and Ram." The Guru taught that Sikhism cannot be caged in Hinduism or in any other belief system. On this anniversary of Vaisakhi, we should pledge ourselves to resist both threats and blandishments and live and promote the Sikh teachings of equality, tolerance and freedom of belief in a world that seems to have lost its ethical direction. Vaheguru Ji Ka Khalsa, Vaheguru Ji Ki Fateh.